Good morning. A young police officer has been rushed to hospital after being slashed in the neck during a violent confrontation in Sydney's southwest. Jared Brevi is live on the scene for us. Jared, good morning. What sparked the incident?
Good morning, Davina. Well, what we know is that just before 7 this morning, police arrived at a home here on Heckenberg Avenue at Sadlier in relation to a warrant, but things quickly turned very ugly. A man at the address allegedly confronted police and a 24-year-old male constable was stabbed in the neck and shoulder. Now, his colleagues did manage to stop things going any further and they called for backup. A large number of police flooded the area and they did manage to bring the situation under control, arresting two men. That injured police officer was taken to Liverpool Hospital. We're told he's now in a serious but stable condition. We have spoken to residents who live on this street and saw it all unfold.
It was so shocking. There was a struggle there in the driveway. The police was asking the dude to just stay down. It was a bit of a the challenge to kind of keep him at bay.
Now, as you can see, there is still a large police presence here at the scene. The street remains cordoned off as police conduct some very extensive investigations. We do expect to hear more details about this incident when police update the media later today. Davina.
A chilling crime scene there, Jared. Thank you. Well, there were fears and echoes of 9/11 in New York City with a helicopter crashing into a Manhattan skyscraper. Nine's US Bureau Chief Robert Penfold has more.
Well, for a while there was real panic in New York, as you can imagine, with the report of an aircraft crashing into a building and on fire as well. Now, confirmation now that the pilot was killed, but at least all the damage was contained to the rooftop of that New York skyscraper. Now, which is pretty close to the always busy Times Square area of Manhattan. There was rain and fog hanging over the city at the time, very difficult flying conditions, and firefighters were there quickly and had to get all the way up to fight that fire to the top of the building because that chopper was really burning by then. That building is 51 stories high, but when it hit, when that chopper hit, the people inside on all the floors knew straight away there was a problem.
We could basically feel it when the building shook.
It was very scary that everybody had to run out. They thought it was like 9/11.
It wasn't until we got outside of the building that we understood that it was actually a helicopter that hit the building.
And thank God no other people were injured in this absolutely shocking, stunning incident.
Now, it does look very much like it was a pilot in distress and someone actually heading for the highest spot he could crash land onto. Now, at the same time, by crashing the chopper up there, the pilot looked undoubtedly saved a lot more lives, because right there, just before 2 in the afternoon, despite the terrible weather there in New York, the Manhattan streets are always teeming with people. Of course, an aircraft into a building also raised the specter of a terrorism act, but now that seems to be not the case. But just repeating, this helicopter has crashed in New York into a building, claiming the life of a pilot.
There is a new battleground over the government's proposed income tax cuts, with Senate crossbenchers wanting action to cut gas and electricity prices. We'll go live to Canberra and our political reporter Jonathan Kersley. Jono, good morning. Take us through who wants what.
Davina, Centre Alliance has two senators, Rex Patrick and Sterling Griff. They are concerned the benefits of the government's proposed tax cuts could be erased by rising power prices. So they want more government action to end the rises and cut what households are paying before it backs the government's $158 billion income tax package in full. Nine News has been told the two senators told Finance Minister Matthias Cormann they are concerned about forecasts of gas prices rising right up until 2023-2024. So to put a halt to that, they want a gas reservation of 15% here in Australia for domestic use, basically to ensure there are reserves held here in Australia before gas is shipped overseas as part of government contracts. There's one established already in Western Australia, but not elsewhere. And the Centre Alliance senators believe having a national reserve could help make prices fall. But Government Senator Zed Seselja says the Centre Alliance senators don't need to choose between energy prices and income tax cuts.
Certainly not one or the other. You know, we certainly believe in taking strong measures to bring power prices down, and that's what we've been engaging in over the last few years and will continue to engage in. We don't support big energy companies profiteering.
Labor leader Anthony Albanese is maintaining his party won't support the latter stages of the cuts because they are beyond this election cycle. So for the legislation to pass, the government needs four crossbenchers. Pauline Hanson and One Nation have already said at this stage they won't back them. That's why Centre Alliance's support becomes important, because if Stirling Griff and Rex Patrick back the cuts, so too do Corey Bernardi and Jackie Lammy, then the package will pass, Davina.
Jono, we'll see what happens. Thank you. A teenage girl is fighting for her life after the car she was in hit a concrete pillar on Melbourne's Monash Freeway. The vehicle ran off the road at Mulgrave just after midnight, with the crash shutting down the freeway for a number of hours. The teenager was taken to the Alfred Hospital in a critical condition with a head injury. The driver, a man in his 40s, along with a woman in her 40s, and another teenage girl were all transported to hospital in a stable condition. A teenager's been capsicum sprayed as hundreds of hoons were busted across Melbourne overnight. As Sam Cucciara explains, organisers and attendees are set to pay a hefty price.
Almost 300 hoons were expected to be slapped, with almost $250,000 worth of fines following a number of illegal meets across Melbourne overnight. This vision obtained by Nine News shows them dicing with death under a cloud of smoke, doing burnouts at the back of an industrial estate at Killor Park before fleeing as police arrive. This morning, workers and business owners returned to an absolute mess, with car parts and shredded tyres scattered for hundreds of metres.
Oh God. 300 people, that's a lot. I didn't know it was that extent, but yeah, it's pretty terrifying that that's what's going on. I don't want anyone hurt. That's the last thing. That's my main concern, is I don't want anyone to get hurt.
Anyone who participated or just simply attended as a spectator last night is being warned they could receive an $800 fine in the mail in coming days. Meanwhile, a 17-year-old boy who was pepper sprayed will be charged with hindering police.
A Sydney father revealed he first thought his children had a virus when arriving home to find them suffering the effects of carbon monoxide poisoning. The cause of the gas leak is still under investigation, but there's speculation it may have been a fault in a recently installed pool filter or a problem with the ducting system. The entire family was taken to hospital.
The kids, they all just felt dizzy and fell on the floor. One of my sons was great. He called 000 straight away.
Mr. O'Neill confirmed the family of seven is back home and doing well. A burst water main has caused drama at an outlet shopping centre in Melbourne. The pipes started bursting water at the Essendon DFO around 8:30 this morning and quickly flooded the car park. Repair works are now underway. Well, Prince Philip has rung in his 98th birthday, with members of the royal family posting touching tributes on social media to mark the milestone. Ebony Cavallaro reports the celebrations took place, though, behind closed doors.
Well, there was no public event, but there was a gun salute, and that is a tradition. And today, tributes were flowing in for the Duke of Edinburgh to celebrate his 98th birthday. He was celebrated on social media by senior and younger royals alike, who posted a series of photos. There were some very recent ones, including one with baby Archie, and some beautiful throwback shots that gave a very rare and personal insight into Prince Philip. There's one of him in his military uniform, one with a two-year-old Prince Charles, and another of him dancing with the Queen. Now, many people have asked why he wasn't at the Queen's official birthday celebrations on the weekend. Well, there's a simple answer. It's that he's actually retired from public life, and that's why we don't see him out in public very often anymore.